I spoke to Uche, and I said, Lillian, we agreed to issue a statement yesterday that people should restrain from celebration today because of the economic and the situation in the country. It's a civil to all the issues we have. And then was advised that issues of billboards and the newspapers should be avoided. But fortunately this afternoon, I went to the paper. I saw so many publications in spite of those warnings. I want to thank those who defied my order. I want to thank my friend, my brother, my ally, the Honorable Minister for Foreign Affairs, and his lovely wife, for always finding time to come and celebrate with us. And on behalf of my family, I said that celebration will never cease in your home.
Amen.
Humility is a legacy.
Yes.
Taking this fight to take you more and more.
Yes.
And for all of our friends, I just want to thank you because you really colored my life. I want to thank all of you because you're always there for us. On a lighter note, when they were taking the photographs, I just looked at my tummy and I was like, so I tried as much as I was going to talk it to you. I learned this trick that I told you, remember, went to Italy to see Berlusconi, the former Prime Minister of Italy, my friend. So he was like a very short man. So when I took pictures, I discovered that the man was almost the same height as me. I was wondering what happened. So I discovered the man was raising his hand. So I comforted him with this. He had been doing that all his life. I think he was such a tall man, but when he became such a very short man. So I decided to do the same thing this afternoon. So if you see the filter program, you will see a very flat tunnel. So, but don't cheat next time. I want to thank everybody,
yes,
and I believe that by the grace of God, we'll have many, many, many things to celebrate in your various lives.
Amen.
I wish us where God will also do the best for you.
Amen.
And we look forward to a greater future for all of us. And we believe that celebration will never cease in any of our lives.
Amen.
So, and our country will definitely get much better.
Yes. Amen.
It can never, never be worse than what it is now.
Amen.
We can only begin to see progress. Now, as a very resilient country, and I believe we will overcome whatever challenges we have now.
Yes.
Countries like ours have overcome such challenges, from Colombia to Sri Lanka to many other countries, even in Israel,
to Rwanda,
so everywhere, Rwanda. Even Rwanda. So we overcome. So we should not lose hope and we should not despair.
Yes.
All we need is prayers,
yes,
and good leaders to ensure that we get ourselves out of this challenge.
Yes.
I'm very optimistic that will definitely happen, and it will happen at all times.
Yes.
So I want everybody to keep praying for our country and then do our best, wherever we find ourselves, to add our own value to what is happening. There was a Churchill who told the people of England during the Second World War that if everybody defends his home, the people of England is defended. So in our very little ways, let us try to put international development and make sure that whatever we have, let us try to do the best of that. So with that, I'm going to build such a great country. So I'm very, very optimistic that Nigeria will be great again.
Amen.
Thank you all, and God bless you. Jesus' name.
Amen.